Hello friends, Satyendra here, and in this video, let's create multiple holes within one hole feature in Creo Parametric. So let's get started. So if you see this model tree, I have one hole feature here, and within this feature, I have multiple holes here. So this functionality is added from Creo 8. So if you are using Creo 8 or higher version, you can use this functionality to add multiple holes within one hole feature. Now to understand it, let's create the same feature one more time. So I'll first delete this feature and then I'll go for hole. So before Creo 8, within the placement tab, you was having 5 different placement. You was having linear placement, radial placement, diameter placement, coaxial placement and on point placement. Now from Creo 8, you have one more placement, which is sketch placement. So if you go for sketch placement, you can define a sketch to place multiple holes within one hole feature in Creo Parametric. So I'll just go for sketch. I'll say normal and I will draw the sketch. I'll place a center rectangle here. I'll take this dimension as 50. So you can create a sketch using line segment. You can use line, rectangle, but you cannot use circle, arc, ellipse or spline. So your sketch must have the line segment. You can even go for palette, and from here you can add all the polygons, you can add profiles, or you can even add the shapes, but make sure that your shapes doesn't have arc or circle. So you can go for cross. You cannot go with rounded rectangle, racetrack or arc racetrack. So you can add all the sections which has the line segment. So I've created a center rectangle here. Now I'll say OK. So the moment you say OK, it starts adding the holes. Now just increase the diameter. Let's make it 10. So see here, this rectangle has 4 vertices here. So you're getting the holes in all 4 vertices. Now you're getting these holes because you have selected this option. If you select the midpoint, then you start getting holes in the mid of this line. If you uncheck this, then you get holes only on the midpoint. If you select this, you get holes to all the vertices here. Then you can even place a datum point. So if I go to edit, normal, and if I place datum point somewhere here, 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 and here, I'll just go for equal. I'll make this dimension equal to this, this, and this, and then I will modify this dimension. This one, I'll make it 18. So here I have placed 5 datum points. I'll say OK. Now you see, you're getting holes onto the datum point just because you have selected this. If you uncheck this, you'll not get that. If you uncheck this, you'll not get that. If you uncheck this, you'll not get the hole. If you select this, you're getting holes on all the datum points. So this functionality is working just like point pattern. You can select all 3 options together and then you can say OK. You got the holes. So the same functionality also works for standard hole. So if I shift to standard hole and then if I go for M10, you see, I can define the depth through all and I can say OK. So you are having M10 hole, totally 13 numbers. Now let's change the sketch. This time I'll just delete this sketch and I'll go for palette, and from here I'll add 6-sided hexagon. Make it 40. Say OK. Repaint. say OK. You see. Not only that, you can have overlap geometry here. Let's say I am creating a overlap geometry like this. I'll say OK. Now see, mid of this line is getting this hole. One more time, I'll go for line. I'll add one more line like this and like this. Then one more line like this and like this. This line I will delete it and I will place one more line like this. So here you have a broken segment like this. Say OK. And now see, because this line is a broken segment, you have a midpoint for this line also. So you are getting this hole, this hole, this hole, this hole, and this hole. All these holes because you have these lines as a broken segment. If you have a line starting from here till here, then you will have one circle here, another circle here, and another circle here. So this way you can add multiple holes within one hole feature in Creo Parametric. And this functionality looks awesome because you don't need a pattern feature to pattern the holes. So this was the multi-hole feature in Creo Parametric, and I hope you will like this. Now let me know your thoughts about this function in the comments below, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.